Hello guys, so in this video we are going to discuss one topic, radiation from current element, that is alternating current element. This topic is under the subject antenna and wave propagation. So let's start. So let us first consider that this is a current element placed at the center of the spherical coordinate. Here we are considering spherical coordinate system. Okay, so this is the origin O, and the current element IDL cos omega t. Why cos omega t? In electromagnetics we call current element as IDL only, but here the current element is alternating current element, so we are considering this sinusoidal part cos omega t. So this is the current element placed along z axis. Okay, this is the z axis, this is x, y and z axis. So now what we have to do, we have to calculate the radiation. So radiation means the electric and magnetic field components. So let's calculate this radiation at some point P over here. So, and let's say this point P is at a distance R from the origin. So this is origin. So this is the distance R. So from the concept of electromagnetics, we know that the vector potential, or more specifically, to be more specific, we can say the retarded vector potential at a point R. Okay, let's say the radiation is moving with velocity small v. Okay, small v is the velocity of radiation. So what we can write, the retarded vector potential is mu naught by 4 pi volume integral. This is the volume. Okay, so volume integral j of t minus R by v. So here v is the volume, so don't get confused with this two v. This v is velocity while this v is the volume. So since only z component is present, because it is present along z axis, so as the current element is placed along z axis, the vector potential will also have only one component along z axis. So more specifically, we can write this as the only z component, which is mu naught by 4 pi j of t minus r by v dv dash. This r by v is dimension of time only, because r is distance and this is velocity, so distance upon velocity is time. So this is nothing but retarded potential, retarded by time, this by this amount. So this also has the component only along z axis. Now let's start. We know that I dot dl equals to k into ds equals to j dot dv, j into dv. This is the current element, which can be represented like this and like this also. This K is surface current density. So this is surface current density, means current per unit length. So current per unit length into area. It has dimension of current into length. Similarly, this is current per unit area. So current plus unit area into volume. This is dimension of length, and this is dimension of I into DL, means current into length. So dimensionally we can write like this. This is current per unit length, remember that. So by this relation we can write AZ as mu naught by 4 pi. We can write this volume integral j of t minus r by v dv dash as I into dl cos omega t minus r by v. The whole term is inside the cosine term. So by modifying this AZ, we will get this modified AZ. Okay, and divide by R is always there. Now our aim is to find electric field E and magnetic field H. So in this video we will find the magnetic field H first, and from that, by using that magnetic field component, we will find electric field by using the relation of Maxwell between E and H. So let's start by calculating the value of H. Now how we will calculate the value of H? So now we know that del cross A equals to B. Del cross A equals to B. Alright. What is B? B is mu naught into H. It is magnetic field. This is H is magnetic field. This is magnetic field per unit area, that is magnetic flux density. Okay, so this mu not into H, so H is nothing but del cross A by mu. So our aim is to find del cross A. We know the value of A by this equation. So let's say this is equation number 1. And let's say this is equation number 2. So what we have to do? We have to find the curl of A. Now, how to find the curl of A? So curl of A can be found like this. We know by the formula of curl that, I hope you are knowing. So we can write like this now. So for this, what we have to find? We have to find AR, A theta and A phi. We know the component Z only, because we know that A has only one component, which is given by Z. Okay, so we have only Z component and we have to find this components AR, A theta and A phi. So how to find? Now we know that AR equals to AZ into AR unit vector. Any component R can be found by multiplying the given A, which is nothing but AZ only, by its unit vector in the given direction, or we can say in the required direction. So what we will do, we know that this is AZ and we know that Z dot R is nothing but cos theta. This is from electromagnetics. Don't worry if you are not knowing this, please check the thumbnail of this video or check the description. I will provide it in the description. Similarly, A theta is nothing but AZ into A theta, or specifically we can also write like this, A into AR, and AR has only one component AZ, so I am directly writing AZ. And Z dot theta is nothing but minus sine theta, so minus sine will appear over here. And similarly we can write A phi as AZ into A phi, but since Z into phi is 0, because both have 90 degree angle, Z into phi is 0, so we can write A phi component as 0. So substituting these values now in the given equation, so del cross A is nothing but 1 upon R square sine theta AR. So we can write like this by substituting the value of AR, A theta and A phi. Now we know how to open determinant. So by opening this along this AR first column, this is 0 minus del by del phi of AZ minus of AZ sine theta. But we know that from equation 1, AZ is only dependent on R and this is with respect to phi. So this term is considered constant. So differentiating constant will lead to 0. So this AR component will be 0. Similarly, by expanding along this R A theta, we will write del by del R of 0, which is 0, minus del by del phi of AZ cos theta. Again, Z is only dependent on R. So this term is constant because it is differentiation with respect to phi. So the A theta component is also 0. So now let's expand along this R phi, A phi component. So what we can write, R sine theta into A phi times del by del R of this whole component, because AZ is now dependent on R. So differentiation is not 0. Similarly, this is dependent on theta, though Z is not dependent on theta, but this is dependent on theta, so the differentiation is not 0, AZ will be considered as constant.